Civilian Oversight Board, and I think it sounds like a very good idea for Ann Arbor. I think that, you know, we'll wait to see what comes out of the audit of the police department and see how exactly what the power and features of this group would be. But I think a neutral outside board providing some checks and balances to our police would be in keeping with our community values and also a good governance for our city and our role as a leader in the state of Michigan and around the country with regards to civilian oversight of our law enforcement. I think it's in keeping with our community values, and I will look forward to seeing the result of the police audit and moving forward on it as designed.
Thanks for your answer. Mr. Frenzel, the question again is about a civilian police review board. What features of a civilian oversight board do you think are critical for effectiveness, and which would you support as a council member?
Fabulous. Just to start off, I'd like to mention Chief Baird specifically in this conversation. Through one-on-one conversations and as well as through the budget process, I have found our chief, the leader of our department, to be very accessible and interested in the report and what that outputs. In fact, he has leaned towards us and asked to not increase staffing, police staffing at this point, in hopes that the recommendations coming out will be other types of strengths on the force, be it social work or other ride-alongs, structural elements within the department, which I think are critical. Over the last handful of weeks and months, it has, as Hillard Hines has moved forward with their interviewing of staff and city council and residents, has become increasingly clear that a third-party outside organization is starting to have challenges reaching certain portions of our community. It is very hard to grapple with and grab people who don't want to be seen or who feel ostracized by the police, and I think it is very important that some of us, especially myself on council, have been pushing both that organization forward in moving those issues forward, including those voices, but also to ensure that they get heard well. The board itself, I think, plays a critical role in both a check and balance process as well as a transparency process. Our boards and commissions in general do a great job of activating our citizens and allowing them to participate in the government. In doing that directly and in meaningful ways, critical to this process.
Thank you.